We're not going to hit the rewind button. Jay Gruden and the Redskins look ahead. Redskins coach Jay Gruden ultimately decided it was better to move on than to dwell on comments safety DJ Swearinger made about the team's blah practices following Sunday's ugly 30-13 loss to the Los Angeles Chargers. "Not really," Gruden said during Wednesday's press conference with reporters when asked whether he had a chance to talk to Swearinger about the safety's criticism of the team's preparation. "I think everything that's been said has been said already, and we're not going to hit the rewind button, so we're just going to move forward, and try to prepare the best we can for the Arizona Cardinals. We've got a whole new game plan and we're fired up to play the Cardinals in front of our home fans and go from there. Put the last two games behind us and the reasons why we lost, there's millions of them we can point to, but the fact of the matter is we gotta let it go and move on." Regi, Redskins are plagued by a never-ending vicious cycle. Gruden shouldered much of the blame for the Redskins' poor performance against the Chargers. On Monday, he said he hadn't seen video of Swearinger's post-game comments, but that he planned to talk with Swearinger the following day. Gruden has praised Swearinger's leadership throughout the season and empathized with the frustration the safety voiced after a second consecutive defeat dashed the Redskins' minuscule playoff hopes. "I think sometimes after a loss you get a microphone stuffed in your face and sometimes you get emotional and you say things that kind of, you mean well, but they get taken out of context," Gruden said. "It's happened to me once or twice, by golly. I don't really see a whole lot into it. I know that DJ plays his heart out there. He's not perfect, nor am I, but I love his passion for the game." As the Redskins continue preparation for their final three games of the regular season, quarterback Kirk Cousins agreed with his coach's sentiment. "You learn from the past and you certainly want to make sure it doesn't repeat itself, but there's no doubt that you do need to wipe it, you need to hit the reset button a little bit," said Cousins, who threw for a season-low 151 yards against the Chargers. "You need to just move forward and not allow anything emotionally to linger. We talk about being mentally and emotionally tough. Mentally and emotionally tough people are able to do that. It's human nature to kind of let stuff linger, or get yourself in a pattern that's negative, and we just can't do that." Gruden also provided an update on Redskins tight end Jordan Reed, who was placed on injured reserve Tuesday. Reed may have surgery on the injured toe that caused him to miss all of training camp and likely contributed to the hamstring injury that kept him out of Washington's last six games. Reed, who finished the season with 27 catches for 211 yards, is due to see another specialist. Josh Norman sat out Wednesday's practice with a knee injury, but Gruden said it isn't anything serious. Rookie Jonathan Allen is eligible to return this week from the foot injury he suffered in a Week 6 win over the San Francisco 49ers, but the defensive lineman did not participate Wednesday. "I think if he's got any kind of doubt or the doctors have any kind of doubt whatsoever, we're going to hold him off," Gruden said. "So we gotta make sure they're sure and they're not quite sure yet. They need more time." Read more on the Redskins. Redskins' Dustin Hopkins back at practice, could return this season. This is the scariest number for the Redskins. Jay Gruden taking all the blame for Redskins' woes. Sound familiar, Regi? Redskins are plagued by a never-ending vicious cycle. Suwa Cravens cleared to return to football. Will he do so with the Redskins? Jordan Reed's season is over after Redskins place him on